Sometimes truth is stranger than fiction. Let me give you an example of one such case. I'm a product person, and like a lot of product people, we ask a lot of simple questions without having many of the answers ourselves. In my case, my questions are about casinos. I've been to over 600 casinos, not because I'm a professional gambler, although I can hold my own at a blackjack table, but because I've installed, designed, and created products for the casino gambling industry for 18 plus years. If you've walked inside a casino, you've interacted with code or hardware that I've worked on. The word casino comes from the Italian, meaning a small house. And ever since the beginning, these establishments have really been known for the table game. A table game is defined by a game of chance, usually played with some kind of cards, chips, or dice. And it's no secret that since the beginning, the casino has tried to watch this table game. In fact, in the old days, they used to have false ceilings with people sitting up there watching the game. Modern-day casinos use cameras. And these cameras are utilized for recording and monitoring all kinds of activities on the casino gaming floor. In fact, more than likely, the casino floor has more cameras per square foot than any other environment that any of us have public access to. But surprisingly, until quite recently, we have been unable to embed any kind of computer vision or AI to monitor what's occurring on the casino gambling table. Weird, no? You would think a place that has had surveillance for hundreds of years is the one place that an AI computer vision model would go first. But turns out, the real world is a lot more complex than an AI model. So, what do we do? Well, there's two things to consider here. Number one, the viewing angles, for as great as these cameras are in the sky, are not necessarily capable of embedding computer vision. And number two, even in a casino, no one likes a camera in their face. So one of the ways we can go about this is play the same kind of hand the Greeks dealt the Trojans in the legendary Trojan Wars. And what I mean is embed it into something that sits on the table already and use a Trojan horse. What you see here is a device that you may have walked by if you've been to a casino and never even thought of it twice and not even looked at it before. But today, and quite recently, these devices have embedded technology in them that allow you to monitor the casino table in ways never seen before. Normally, you would be surprised to know that a lot of these functions that are getting performed are done by the human eye. There's quite literally people watching you wager at the table. Not anymore. And so, as we bring these things to the market, we're able to augment data aggregation using our technology, things that are usually done by people. So why does any of this matter? Well, just like productizing anything, productizing AI must try and create value for all the stakeholders involved. And we do that in three distinct ways in our case: with people, with risk, and with reward. The table game staff is the most prominent staff of people on the casino floor. And over many years, we have inundated them with so many screens and so much technology, they spend more time typing at those screens than interacting with the guest. With cameras that are able to do things better than people can do things better that people can. So we're able to elevate this good friction. There's a famous professor at MIT called Dr. Gosling. She talks about good friction and bad friction. And using AI, we can elevate the good friction, the customer service, and downgrade the bad friction, the time spent typing things on screen. So we're able to augment the experience for the player and the staff. On to risk. Now, it's no secret that ever since table games have existed, people have tried to alter the odds in their favor. The famous MIT blackjack team comes to mind. I'm sure many of you have heard of it. There might even be someone in here who may have practiced some of these arts. Game protection is a very important concept of the industry. And certainly, cameras can view the table a lot better than people. So again, we're able to augment the experience of the operator. And finally, rewards. So the way the industry uses rewards, they use something called a player rating system. And the player rating is built on average bet. An average bet is determined by your initial buy-in, your first starting bet, and the duration of play. And that determines important stuff, basically what the casino wants to comp you, your free breakfast, your hotel rooms, etc. We can augment that with cameras so that the players are able to more efficiently, consistently, in a more fair manner, gain the rewards instead of the human eye. So finally, next time when you walk into a casino, you might think about the AI that's running in the background. The AI that's aggregating data and essentially able to pamper to your preferences in the future. So it's getting you your breakfast and your show tickets more accurately. And generally speaking, as many of us are innovators and designers and we create products and implement AI in the real world, we should think about minimizing the environmental factors and the impact of that AI while maximizing the data aggregation and pattern matching it offers. And maybe, just maybe, along that journey, you might hire a product person to ask the simple questions. Thank you.